Hello everyone, welcome to my podcast. Today my guest is the icon of portrait photography, Sean Archer. Welcome, and I'm super excited to have you, and thank you for accepting my invitation to this podcast. I'm really appreciate it, and thank you for your time. So I know we have a little bit of shortage of time, so let's jump into this. So first question, what I would like to...
Hello, and thank you so much.
Oh, my pleasure. You know, this is absolutely honor for me to have you. And you know, just the fact I can talk to you, it's for me. I'm super excited. Okay, so let's jump into right away. And my first question is, if you could tell me a little bit about your story, how did you get into photography? Like, I know you've been doing this for such a long time, but how did you start it? You know, what was the process getting into it? And if you could just give me a little bit of backstory of you know, getting into this entire process.
You know, 6 years ago, I bought my first camera.
Okay.
It was Panasonic Lumix G3, not very expensive camera with very cheap kit lens. And you know, I was an absolute beginner. I knew nothing about photography, absolutely nothing. And you know, I just started to shoot everything.
Okay.
And then, by the way, you know, I can show you this because I have some slides for my workshop. So maybe if you're interested, I can share my screen with you and I will show you some pictures.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Let's try it. 1 second. And look at this. Oh, do you see it?
Yes.
It was my first camera, exactly like this, white one. And this girl, she was my friend, and she's still my friend, of course. And she asked me to make a portrait of her. And she said, you bought a camera, so you are a photographer now.
Okay.
And of course, I said, yeah, I'm a photographer now, let's try. And of course, this shot, not from our first experience, not from our first photo shoot. First one was, of course, it was really bad. But to my big surprise, my first shots were, somehow they were better than some shots from professional photographer who worked with her earlier. And this guy, he took money, so he kind of professional. And I saw his work, and I think, how? He don't understand angles. He don't understand light. So, of course, maybe his camera is much more expensive, and he uses professional light, but result was worse than mine.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe I was curious, and I started to shoot. And, you know, for my first 2 years, I shoot absolutely everybody for free.
Okay.
You know, everybody. Different people, different ages, different sexes. So I worked with everybody. It was my start. And I worked with this camera. And, you know, as I told you, I was an absolute beginner. I worked in portrait mode, you know, full auto mode in your camera.
Yep.
All you have to do just to press the button. And for my first 2 years, I worked in my in portrait mode. And I will show you this. This is part of my home, and you see, this is where I work. My window, my wall. So this is my little home studio.
Okay. Well, that's pretty amazing. And you know what? I'm glad you're talking about it because, you know, we're living in this era right now where, you know, everything is pushed to buying more expensive equipment, more expensive lights, but people don't really go after the essence of photography, right? So
I worked with this camera, and of course it wasn't expensive camera, and no expensive lenses. And look at this. This is the only light I have, this light from this window, that's all. But it was more than enough for me, and I still love to work in this small studio. Now I have a lot of possibilities, but I still love this room, and I work a lot in this room because really that's all I need to make good portraits.
Perfect. Awesome. Okay, so my next question is, you know, like, who inspired you when you started? Did you have any photographers who, you know, you look up to and you, I don't know, challenge? Like, who inspired you to develop, you know, the style of photography you have? You're already showing me this.
Yes, you can see it here. They're not photographers. My inspiration are not photographers. My inspiration is classic art.
Okay.
So look at this here. You can see a portrait of Rembrandt on the left and my portrait on the right, and you see there are a lot of similar things here. the same, maybe the same light, the same texture, the same colors. And you know, when I started to make portraits, I always have in mind what is great portrait for me. And mm-hmm. it was always classic art, maybe classic Dutch art, you know, from mm-hmm. from masters like Rembrandt, Vermeer, and so on. So I always try to create something similar. So when a lot of when people ask me, what is my art, how I describe my own style, my own photography, I always say it's classic portrait art plus pinup. Because you see, maybe on the right you can see perfectly beautiful girl, a little bit of smile, maybe it's a little bit sensual, but at the same time, really, it's classic portrait art. So my inspiration is really classic art.
Okay, so that leads me to my next question. Like, I want to just talk about components of, you know, good portrait. And I know there's lighting, there's texture, there's person, but how do you break this down? Like, what is kind of the most important part for you when you actually start shooting? Like, are you trying to kind of make all of those components work together, or you have this kind of, I don't know, some kind of system where you're breaking this whole thing down and you're going after those, each of those components? I hope that question make any sense, but I just want to kind of break this down a little bit and then kind of understand.
I believe good portrait art is composition.
Okay.
Composition, light, and color, three parts. And okay. I always try to, you know, to make it perfect. Perfect composition, perfect light, and perfect color. Of course, you know, when you work with natural light, it's impossible to get perfect light. So I do it in post-work. Post-work is really important for me because, you know, I believe now you have to be more than just a photographer, because there are a lot of photographers around us. Everybody is a photographer. Mm-hmm. So I believe now you have to be more. You have to be an artist. So you see how I work. My photography basically is just a start, but then when I work with my shots, I try to add something from me, and this is perfect light, colors, and of course my final result sometimes it's a little bit different from the original shot, and I will show you how. Mm-hmm. For example, look at this shot. You see, I made this 6 years ago, and it was my first attempt to work outside. It was my first outdoor photo shoot. And look at this. You see, of course, this shot is far from perfect. I think everybody can make a shot like this. It's a no-brainer. But of course, look at her. She's perfect. Really beautiful girl. Mm-hmm. But shot itself is kind of boring. Colors are lame. So I think this is far from good. And look at this. This was my first attempt. Mm-hmm. After post-work, and you see, it's a little bit different. Of course, her face now is the center of the composition, and you can see interesting highlights in her eyes and warm highlight on her face. And I was, you know, quite happy with this shot. But a little bit later, I saw something is not good here. For example, look at the background. You can see this sunny forest, and sunny forest, you know, it's a perfect place to shoot happy kids, kittens, puppies. But her face doesn't connect with this forest, with this background. And I thought, somehow I have to improve it. I have to do something. And look at this. I will show you my final result from this shot. Mm-hmm. And you see, it's completely different. It's completely different from the previous shot. And of course, it's different from the original shot. Because I worked with this shot as an artist. And you see, it's not only black and white. You see, I completely painted it black, I mean background. Mm-hmm. And now you can see a lot of freckles on her face. And it was, by the way, it was really one of my really successful shots. Mm-hmm. And I realized, you know, nobody cares about your original shot. Nobody cares about your camera, about your lens, about your post-work and so on. Everybody cares about final result. What you will show to your viewers, to your spectators. So I think I realized that for me, post-work is not a technical tool. It's a creative tool. If you can make something bigger from your original shot, I think you have to do it. I think maybe now it's the only way for photographers.
Mm-hmm. So okay, that's amazing, and then, you know, like, I couldn't agree more with you. So my next question is, so how you develop that, like, what is the process of, you know, going from, as you said, like, just the average shot where everybody can take, and then, you know, how you can kind of develop the vision throughout shooting to kind of, you can go from, you know, kind of average shot to this amazing image. And so my question is, how did you develop that? That was just mostly because you were shooting a lot, or you were trying different things? Like, what was your process of kind of getting to that kind of higher level of creating those stunning images?
You know, I have some kind of artistic background.
Okay.
I graduated architectural academy.
Okay.
And I'm trained as a professional artist. So you see, I can paint, I can draw. And it was very important for me because I understood a lot of things about composition, mm-hmm. light, and new light, and new shadows, and new composition. It was my first step. Because, you know, when I take my first shots, I realized that those shots are far from perfect. Light is far from perfect. Mm-hmm. And somehow, I have to improve this. And second, you know, of course, about post-work, about Photoshop. You know, I knew Photoshop before because I worked as a broadcast designer. As a graphic designer at local TV station, I was a chief designer at local TV station. So Photoshop was part of my work. And you know, in the beginning, I tried all photographers' method, like frequency separation. You know, mm-hmm. photographers use a lot of things like such this. And I was very frustrated mm-hmm. because result always was very artificial. You know, artificial skin mm-hmm. and so on. And I started to work with my shots, not as a photographer, but as a graphic designer, mm-hmm. as an artist. It was completely different way, and I found my own way in post-work. And I tried to keep original texture, for example, original texture of the skin. But at the same time, it's much faster and much simpler. And I always try to make final result closer to classic portrait work. Mm-hmm. And that's how it's worked. You see my background, plus my post-work method, because again, I worked with my shots not as a photographer, but more as a graphic designer.
Okay. So how long, if I can ask you, like, how long usually takes you to work on let's say, on image? Because I know there's a huge discussion nowadays, and it seems like also there's two kind of schools, right? One of them is telling, like, okay, you don't want to spend too much time on the computer. There are some other schools who are saying, like, you know, in order to create something interesting, like, you have to put the time into it, right? So what's your approach to retouching images?
Of course, if you go creative, so if you will try different crops, different colors, different textures, I can work 30 minutes because I will try a lot of different ways. If I will go, you know, simple way, just like to make a good portrait from an average, from a typical original shot, about 10, 15 minutes.
Okay, perfect.
So usually it's about 15, 20 minutes, not more.
Okay. So my next question, I'm going to just kind of not change the topic, but I'm going to kind of take this kind of with a different path. So over the last 10 years, we've noticed that, you know, the photography and technology and equipment and Photoshop and ability to work on those images from completely different angles, and the stuff that we can do is like a pretty much, you know, sky is the limit. Mm-hmm. What was the biggest change over the last, let's say, few years, which make the most impact on your images? Is the gear? Is the Photoshop? Is the creative part? Like, what the changes you have seen, which impact your work the most?
You know, I believe I became a photographer because of this digital revolution.
Okay.
Because, you know, photography was much harder 20 years ago.
Yes.
20 years ago, film, it was more expensive, and it was, you know, not so easy to develop your film and so on. And, I'm kind of lazy. So mm-hmm. I can't work, for example, for 2 or 3 hours. That's why maybe I will never be a good artist, because, you know, it takes a long time to create a good portrait if you're an artist, to draw it,
yes,
even with the pencil. So it's a long story. But photography, for me, it's just fine. For example, if I work 30 minutes, maybe 20 minutes on the portrait, for me, it's really good. I'm okay with this. It's perfect time for me. I'm not go to, you know, to long distance, but I love to run to short distances. So it's the same about this. Digital technology helped me a lot, because I think now it's time for artists, because before really photography was from, you know, like you have to be an expert in photography. Yes. Really. So you have to understand a lot of things. You have to understand how your camera works. You have to understand all the camera settings and so on. And you know, when I started, I wasn't expert at all. Mm-hmm. I was an absolute beginner, and I worked in full auto mode and portrait mode. And for me, it was a beginning, and it was, you know, I think everybody can start like this now. Mm-hmm. Now you don't have to be an expert photographer to make a good shot. You can buy modern camera, and it's so good, because now all the technology is, you know, is inside your camera, and you can perfectly work even in auto mode, and you can make really good shots. So of course, accessibility mm-hmm. of photography is really, really important now, because now everybody can be a photographer. So now it depends not on your camera, maybe not on your lens, but it depends on your creative and artistic vision. That's why it's more important now than anything.
Perfect. Oh, that's you know, that's that message, it just speaks for itself. Like, thank you for saying that, because I think a lot of, you know, people don't understand nowadays, you know, the ability which we have, and also, you know, and I'm kind of repeating myself, but this whole focus on the gear nowadays is just absolutely insane sometimes, right?
So, you know, I became really popular, and I became most popular photographer at 500 px.
Yes.
With my camera, with Lumix G3, really, it was maybe $300, and with my first lens, so it wasn't great investment at all.
Yes.
So you see, everybody can start like this. You don't, and you know my room. Remember this picture?
Yes.
Just a window and just one wall. So it's again, it's everybody can start like this. You don't need something special. For example, you know, it's interesting. You know, in Moscow they have absolutely amazing studios for photographers. Studios with textured walls, with amazing interiors, and I will show you. You know, they have. It's an old factory, and they have more than 60 different studios.
Wow.
With amazing interiors, with amazing details. Every studio is about 100, 200 square meters, and it's accessible for every photographer. It's not expensive,
mm-hmm.
and it's in Moscow. I think it's like nothing like this in the whole world. Only in Moscow they have those amazing studios. I live in Ekaterinburg. It's far from Moscow. It's 2 hours of flight to Moscow.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have really good studios here for hire, I mean. So, you know, I started in my own room, and that's all I have, and that's all I got. So I believe everybody can work like this, and limit only is your imagination and your skills.
Absolutely. So now I want to kind of dive in into some, I would say, more detailed stuff regarding your work. So I want to talk a little bit about the body language, the face expressions, because those are the things which they stand out in your work, and they just, you know, you master those stuff. So can you tell me and share with me your process of, you know, kind of finding those best, you know, face expressions, and, you know, the posing of your subject, so you getting not only just the person, but you're also getting you know, this essence and the story behind those images.
Of course. For example, look at this. This is my typical photo shoot. And you see, I do a lot of shots.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean a lot. I will show you this. You see, hundreds and hundreds. Usually it's from 300 to 500 shots for every photo shoot. And you know, it's really important, because my models, they are not professionals.
Mm-hmm.
Usually my models, they are just girls next door, and they don't know how to pose, they don't know how to make interesting expressions, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all on me. So it's very important to make a lot of shots. It's very important to communicate with your model, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, you know, sometimes you can create something absolutely great and unique, and when you shoot, you don't know it. For example, look at this shot.
Mm-hmm.
No, it looks funny. You see, model is great, her smile is great, and very interesting connection between her hair and this and her watch. And I will show you. You see, it's there are about 800 shots here, different shots. But I found this one, And I think it's really good. It's really different from others. Mm-hmm. And I will show you what I did with this shot. Now, look at this.
Yes. Well, this is one of my favorite shots of yours. So.
And you see what I did here. I focused mm-hmm. light on her face. Mm-hmm. Background is different. You see now it's green because I wanted to create complementary colors between background and her eyes. Mm-hmm. And of course, I made it brighter and stronger. But you see, first idea was to make a lot of shots. And then, of course, after I do my photo shoot, I check all my shots and I try to find something, because it's not mm-hmm. about model. For example, this girl, she's absolutely amazing, but she's not a model. She is a makeup artist. Okay. And she doesn't like, you know, photo shoots, really. Mm-hmm. It was only her, I don't know, fourth or fifth photo shoot in her life. She really hates it. I don't know why.
Okay.
But and this shot, it's one of my most successful shots ever made. It's one of my popular shots. Mm-hmm. And again, why? Really, I don't know why. Because everything comes together. You see, I made a lot of shots with her, a lot of different shots, but only one was, you know, so great. Of course, maybe I did 10 or 12 shots from the whole photo shoots, but only one was really good. Was really, not really good. I would say great, because really it's with one of my most successful shots. So sometimes it just happens.
Okay.
When everything comes right in one shot. And of course, you have to be ready for this. And you have to make a lot of shots. For example, you know, some photographers, they always wait for one good shot. And they like, they talk to model and like, wait for a little bit, wait. And one click, oh yes. But then later, he will find that, you know, this shot was not good. It was out of focus or something. You know, I don't wait for perfect shot. I do a lot of shots, a lot. And really, sometimes one of them is absolutely amazing. But it just happens. But you have to be ready for this. You have to make a lot of shots with different poses, different facial expressions, and so on.
Perfect. So how do you find the people you photograph? Because you said, like, you know, those are sometimes people, like, next door. But do you, like, I'm sure you've seen in this girl something which inspires you, right? That's just my guess. Like, I'm not kind of like crossing the line or anything, but what I want to say that, you know, sometimes we see someone, and I can tell you just from my kind of photography perspective that, and they have something interesting, right? Which you want to kind of...
Oh, you know, absolutely. I understand. Because, you know, not all people are photogenic.
Really. Yes,
it's a fact. Some people are really photogenic. Some people, you know, camera really loves them.
Yes,
and it's just the fact. For example, you can find really photogenic model, and you can make a lot of shots with her, and a lot of shots will be good. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, for example, you know, a girl, she's beautiful, but she's not photogenic. And sometimes it's a big problem to make a good shot of her. Why? I don't know. Because really, some people are photogenic. It's just right. But at the same time, you know, I told you before that for my first 2 years, I worked with everybody, mm-hmm. absolutely everybody, not only beautiful girls, not only beautiful models, with everybody, different ages, sexes, and so on. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I worked for free.
Okay.
It was very important because, you know, when you work for free, a lot of people will say, oh, maybe I will try because I have nothing to lose. Maybe shots will be good and it will be okay. And of course, when I started to make really good portraits, a lot of people started to use them in social networks, in the social pages, you know, like mm-hmm. Avatars and so on. And a lot of people started to ask, who was the photographer? And my friends, they, of course, they told, it was me. It was me, and I work for free. And, you know, of course, a lot of people, they decided to work with me. And of course, later I became a professional. But 2 years I worked with everybody, and it's a great experience. Because, you know, with not so photogenic people, it's really important to find really, really good poses. It's really important to find good angles. It's really important how to, you know, it's really important to find the perfect light and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a great school for me. It was a very good experience. So, and you know, now, of course, if you have such an experience, it's much easier for you to work with everybody. And you know, another I think very important thing, you know, when you if you will browse portfolios of some photographers, mm-hmm. you will see that they work only with photogenic models. With, for example, sometimes I discover a portfolio of a photographer with 5 models only. Of course, they're all photogenic and he can make a lot of great shots. But if you will browse, for example, my Instagram, you will find that in this year, 2018, you will find about 150 different faces.
Mm-hmm.
150. So you see, I work with a lot of different people. And I always say your skills are more important than your models. Because if you have good skills in photography and in post-work, you can work with a lot of people. If you don't have skills, you can work only with photogenic people. You know, I work with a lot of different people, and sometimes now, of course, sometimes if I see really interesting models, sometimes, of course, I will work with her for free.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's for popularity, of course. It's not for the money. It's about art. Sometimes we want to work together to create something really good.
So how often do you think people shoot? As much as possible, or like what it's your, I would say, advice? Because you said, like, I 100% agree with you when you said, like, you know, you have to work with different people, you have to, you know, find experiences, and you have to somehow, you know, find this perfect shot, right, throughout the kind of work process of working with them. And so my question is to you, like, how often do you shoot? Like, do you shoot what I want to say is, do you split, like, say, half and half, so you shoot half and then you, let's say, retouch and work on those images like a half, or are you trying to shoot as much as you can? And what would be the advice to the young generation, like, you know, when it comes to photo shoot? And you know what I want to add to this also, and this is also what is kind of my experience, the more you shoot, the better you get, right? It's not about sometimes learning and then watching all those videos and stuff, but just go and shoot, because that's what's going to make you a better photographer.
Of course, you have to shoot a lot, but at the same time, you have to develop your skills. Mm-hmm. It's not just you will take, for example, 1,000 shots, and next day 1,000 shots, and mm-hmm. next day again 1,000 shots. It's just boring. Mm-hmm. You have to try to make every shot better. So of mm-hmm. course, it's very important to invest in your knowledge, to invest in your skills.
Yes.
Because you know, it's very important to trying to be better.
Okay.
Trying to be better. Try to make, you know, your shots better. And of course, in the beginning, you know, for a lot of people, it's a big problem to find a model. Mm-hmm. You know, because a lot of people, by the way, it's the biggest problem maybe, because I had this question in my Instagram. I asked portrait photographer what is the most difficult part of their work for them. Mm-hmm. And, you know, finding model was number one. Because a lot of people, they really think that finding a model is a big problem. Why? Mm-hmm. Because they think that, you know, for example, I will show you a good example. They think that model is really young and highly photogenic person. For example, I will show you. Oh, maybe like where is she? Oh, this one. She's not only young and photogenic, she's really popular. She has about 1 million followers on Instagram, and of course every photographer saying, oh, I want to work with this girl. Mm-hmm. But you know, I believe this is a question of popularity. Mm-hmm. Of course, if you work with model like this, you will be popular.
Mm-hmm.
But before, you have to be a good portrait photographer. So my advice to everybody, your models are around you. Start mm-hmm. your work with your friends, with your girlfriend, with your boyfriend, with your father, mother, with your children. And you know, there are a lot of great photographers who started their work with their family. You know, they just started to shoot family, and they became very popular family photographers. So it's the same. Try to make good portraits from people you know. Mm-hmm. It's, by the way, it's very comfortable to work with people you know. Just try to work with your friend, for example. Try with people who will work for you for 3 hours for free, you know, just for you to develop your skills, to understand poses, light, and so on. So in the beginning, it doesn't matter who is your model. work with everybody, work with everybody, work with your friends and so on. But later, of course, if you will be a good photographer, if you will try to make, if you will start to make really good portraits, you know, it's not a problem to find a model, because a lot of models, they will want to work with you. Mm-hmm. And so now, you know, I have a lot of messages from emails from different models from all over the world, and they like, oh, you make a good portraits, I want to work with you. But of course now, you know, I'm popular. Mm-hmm. But before, I started to work with my friends. All my first shots, they were all my friends. So I believe it's first, you have to be a good portrait photographer. Then it's the question of popularity.
Perfect. So my next question is, so what do you think is the future of photography? Where this whole thing is going? Did you ever have a chance to think about it? Or, you know, what kind of changes you would like to see in the future when it comes to photography?
You know, I think, software will be a really strong, will make a strong impact on photography. For example, I believe maybe in some time everybody can make a shot like this, because all this will be made by some kind of plugin or something. Because, you know, cameras, I believe all photographers will use only auto mode, because it will be perfect. They will make great processors and great, you know, software in the cameras. So, of course, software will be really important. Mm-hmm. So, I believe only one thing will matter. Mm-hmm. You are an artist or not. Because, for example, I believe all people will, everybody will get the possibility to make a great shot. Everybody. Mm-hmm. And I think software will be so good that post-work will be installed maybe in your cameras, or maybe it will be just one click. Like, you know, now everybody want, oh, I want a magic button in Photoshop. Make it perfect. I will press this button and my shot will be perfect. Now you don't have this button. Now you have to learn post-work. But maybe, I don't know, in some year, maybe in few years, we will get this magic button and every shot will be real good with just one button.
But, but don't you think that's going to kind of kill your own creativity? Because, you know, if you push the button and the image is done, you don't really have a kind of impact on this image, right? Because that's what you do right now. You know, you're creating, you have some starting point, you have some raw image, and then you develop this as an artist, this to the next level, right?
But at the same time, you know, you have to work with your model, you have to work with poses and everything. So, of course, software will not do everything.
Yes.
Maybe it will do a lot of things, but again, you have to be an artist. If you're an artist, you will find something. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, photography itself never killed an art. You know, mm-hmm. there are still real artists here. But at the same time, we have photography, but real artists, they exist. They draw, they paint, so they work. And I believe in near future, we will still have photographers. But they will be truly artists.
Perfect. So my last question today is, what kind of impact do you want to make on photography, you as an artist?
You know, I'm not a writer. I'm not a mm-hmm. philosopher. I'm not maybe, you know, I don't write very important messages to humanity. You know, I think I just do nice pictures. That's what I do. Mm-hmm. And I never think of myself as a very important person, you know. But at the same time, I believe that, you know, if that my pictures, maybe they will add something really beautiful in this world. Mm-hmm. And, you know, in Russian language, we have very interesting proverb, beauty will save the world. Mm-hmm. And I believe maybe if I will add a little bit more beauty to this world, maybe this world will be a little bit better. Mm-hmm. So maybe this is my only mission.
Perfect. So I have actually one more kind of request. So what would you say to someone who is starting off photography? Someone who, you know, they want to get into this industry, they want to create stunning images, and, you know, you would have to give them one advice, what that would be?
You know, my advice is don't think about money. Because I believe you can get some success, you can be successful, if you don't think about money in the beginning, because it must be your passion. And I believe in every art like this. If you're a musician, if you're a painter and so on, if you think about money, I think maybe you will be limited and you will be frustrated. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, it's not easy to be a successful artist. It's not easy to be a successful actor. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of people who don't have, you know, money from their hobbies. But if you do it for your passion, if you love what you do, I believe you will be happy. Mm-hmm. Because if you do what you love, it's already good. But if you are good at what you do, maybe you will be absolutely happy. So start photography, start do it because you have passion for that, not because you think it's an easy money. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, some people, they really think, oh, I will be a photographer and I will shoot weddings and it's an easy money. I don't have to be a rocket scientist, you know, mm-hmm. to work as a photographer. But at the same time, a lot of people, they really get frustrated because of this. So my position, just love what you do. Just find it. If you will find it, you will be happy.
Awesome. Thank you so much. That was very, very interesting interview. I have to say that one of the best I ever had. You know, like you giving to people a lot of interesting information, which, you know, we don't think about it most of the time, you know, because we just focus on the wrong things sometimes. But your expertise and then your advice and I think just the work itself just speaks really loudly on this world. So I really appreciated your time. I hope I didn't take too much of your time.
It was really interesting.
Yeah, and you know what? I would love to do this again at some point. I hope you will find time again for me, and maybe we'll meet in Poland. I know you're quite often visit that place, so I would love to maybe meet you one day in person and, you know, talk more. So thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
I hope so. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, bye-bye.